Protein is made up of building blocks. I often like to think of it like the alphabet. So there's 26 letters in the alphabet. There's 20 amino acids, and people need a certain amount of amino acids every day for hair, fingernails, for organs, for tissue replacement. These are the building blocks. They're enzymes, they're hormones. They control our metabolism, and it's strings of these 20 amino acids put together in different sequences and different lengths, as few as 3 amino acids and as many as 50,000 in different places in your body. And they really regulate all our metabolism and help build the structure that we are as human beings. So the foods people normally think of that contain protein are animal products. So we've got poultry, beef, pork, fish, dairy products. They do, those are all good sources of protein, but a common misconception is that's the only places where protein are. So really everything has protein. Among the plant foods, the ones that have the most tend to be beans, nuts, and grains. But there's actually protein in every single food. And a huge misconception is that some of the plant foods are missing some of the amino acids, which really isn't true at all. All foods, plant and animal, have all 20 amino acids. They just come in distributions that are different. So to go back to the alphabet analogy here, so just think about a game of Scrabble. If any of you have played Scrabble, there's a lot of common letters in a Scrabble game, like an E and an N and an A and an O and an R. There's very few Z's or Y's or X's or J's, because when you spell a word, you don't need that many of some of the letters. The amino acids work the same way. There's very little tryptophan, very little cysteine. There's lots of glutamate, lots of glutamine. So let's just say that you as an individual needed 40 grams of protein, and there's 20 amino acids. You might think 40, 20, oh, I need 2 grams of each amino acid. It's not true. You need a lot more of some and a lot fewer of others. And really what you need is the optimal proportion of amino acids for all the hair, fingernails, hormones, enzymes, etc. And those proportions are pretty much dead on when you eat animal foods. But most people are surprised. If you look at the distribution in plant foods, it's almost identical. The two outliers are that grains tend to be proportionally low in lysine. They're not missing lysine, it's just proportionally low. And beans tend to be proportionally low in cysteine and methionine, the sulfur-containing amino acids. Not missing, just low. And it turns out when you eat a lot of foods altogether, it almost doesn't matter. We do have this concept in nutrition of complementing your proteins, eating your grains and beans together to make sure the lysine, cysteine, and methionine low points get balanced out by higher proportions of the other one in those foods. It's not even really necessary. Nobody really needs to complement their foods. They really just need to eat a good, healthy diet with good variety, and you'll get all the protein you need. Another one of the main controversies about protein is how much you need. If you're a growing kid, if you're a muscle builder, you must need more and more and more to build. One of the things people don't think about is if you happen to eat extra for the day so that you can build muscle or grow in your body, where would you store it if you didn't need it right away? And it turns out, big take-home message here, there's no storage place for protein. Endless amounts of fat storage, modest amounts of carbohydrate storage, none for protein. It's all functional. So at the end of the day, after you've finished making enzymes, hormones, fingernails, hair, etc., if you didn't use it to make something structural and functional, it's composed of the same carbon skeletons as carbohydrates and fats. And so you just break down whatever you didn't use and turn it into carbohydrates and fats at the end of the day.